want to introduce my coworker, my friend, the program director of the Crossroads Fund, Jane Kimondo.
Good evening, everybody. I'm back. it's so good to see all of you. There are a few seats in front, or maybe not. No, let me just stick to the script for now. So our first award for the evening is the Ron Sable Award. So those of you who are new, we're going to tell you a little something about Ron Sable. Ron was an activist and a moving spirit here in Chicago. He was a doctor at Cook County, now known as the Stroger Hospital. And at that time, Ron provided care to low-income people. He worked across issues, including women's issues and reproductive rights. He also advocated for the just treatment of prisoners and a national health care. So we can say Ron was single payer before single payer was something, and it's still not something. So Ron served as a Crossroads Fund board for 10 years, and we are honored to remember his vision and legacy through this award. So this award goes to Mariame Kaba and Project NIA. That's exactly how I feel. Mariame, I'm so excited and thrilled to be presenting this honor to you. As a fellow person who has a great love for Africa, I think it's just very, very fitting. So for those of you who do not know Mariame, Mariame lived in Chicago for over 20 years, and we will forever be indebted to Mariame for all that she accomplished. Mariame her accomplishments are epic, to say the least. Mariame is a courageous thinker who does not shy away from big ideas and solutions. She's most known for pushing us all to think, imagine, and work for a world without prisons, detention centers, and jail. A world where the community took care of itself and thus made police obsolete. A world where women and girls were honored and did not have to face any form of violence. In a world where youth can be youth and not have their midlife be at 10 years of age. To get us closer to making this a reality, Mariame has moved into action right from her teenage years and is still going strong. Here are a few organizations that she's been involved with: Rogers Park Young Women's Action Team, Chicago Task Force on Violence Against Girls and Young Women, Chicago Freedom School, Wichita Genocide, Circles and Cypher, Project NIA, and many, many more. Mariame, we appreciate you for being a friend, a mentor, an educator, for never letting us forget the power of youth voices or the harm done by the prison industrial complex on communities of color, the importance of solutions that honor the human soul, and the need to accept each other as we are while holding us accountable when they do harm to others. Thank you, Mariame. This short video we're about to see summarizes all this in a very beautiful way.
Welcome to Chicago, this is home for most. This is the home of the wealthy making cameos. This is the house of the heartless, the home of the cold. Man, my dog gets more acknowledgement than homeless folks. This is the house of generations caged in naughty homes. In all the prisons, so resemblance of metrodomes. This is the corner store for greed. This is the market for bodies where millionaires use black men as stepping stones. This is the house of the crooked and the reckless, with John Burns torture people for confessions. This is the place where Mayor Daley's nephew beat it, kids to death and got all free. My cousin serving life for weapons. In certain areas, you feel the negative energy. Seems to be the home of segregation and hostilities. Those with mental illnesses have nowhere left to go. Rahm Emanuel closed most of their facilities. So many deaths that I've become numb to the pain. And all the aldermen just seek personal gain. I knew my homie wouldn't make it when they shot him in the spleen. The closest trauma center 60 miles away. What the fuck they on with us? This shit gon' drive a nigga crazy. I swear to God, this shit gon' drive a nigga crazy. Confined us to the service sector, ain't no social mobility. They treat all of our people like some slaves. This is the house of schools closing and they fire teachers. Home of for-profit churches with corrupted preachers. Nothing here is free, can't seem to get away from fees. This is the home of red light cameras with the parking meters. City full of anger, man, we crank shit up. All the politicians foul, man, they stank shit up. They done left my people hanging like some life alert commercials. Like, help, I'm falling and I can't get up. This is the city full of anger, man, we crank shit up. All the politicians foul, man, they stank shit up. They done left my people dangling like some life alert commercials. Like, help, I'm falling and I can't get up. This is the city full of anger, man, we crank shit up.
Birds flying high, you know how I feel. Sun in the sky, you know how I feel. Breeze drifting on by, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. It's a new life for me, yeah. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. New life for me. Ooh, 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 ooh. And I'm feeling good. Fish in the sea, you know how I feel. River running free, you know how I feel. Blossom on tree, you know how I feel. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good.
Okay, okay, thank you. So everybody who knows me knows this is like excruciating for me. It really is.
No photos.
No photos, yeah, thank you, and no video. I'm really moved, and I wanna thank Crossroads for your recognition of this collective work, really, that I've been part of for over 20 years in the city. I came to Chicago in 1995 with no intention of staying. But the city has a way of drawing you in and keeping you. I love so many people who I've gotten to fight with, who I've gotten to struggle with, who I've gotten to work with over these 20 years. There's a poem by one of my favorite writers, Marge Piercy, and it's called To Be of Use, and I really love it. I read it all the time, and there's a section in it that I want to read. I love people who harness themselves, an ox to a heavy cart, who pull like water buffalo with massive patience, who strain in the mud and the muck to move things forward, who do what has to be done again and again. And I've been really lucky to be part of a group of people who do what has to be done again and again. And I thank you all, really, for your support and your love all of these years. And while I'm no longer in the city, I'm really in the city. I'll always be here. I'll always be back. I'll always be part of the work that's here. As so many people that I have been able to form relationships with are here, so they're really family more than friends at this point. And I want to end with a story that a friend of mine told me years ago that I really love. And it's about a man named Howard Thurman, who some of you probably know in terms of his contributions and legacy in the world. He was born in 1899 in Daytona Beach at a time when Florida was incredibly segregated. And he went to up to seventh grade. No photos or stuff if people are doing that again. So he was basically only able to go until the seventh grade. His family then scraped together all this money, all the money that they had, to send him to high school in Jacksonville, Florida, because they thought that it would be a place where he would actually be able to, better his life and improve his odds in the future. And when Thurman left home, he went to the train station to get to Jacksonville. And when he got there, they told him that he had to pay extra money in order to be able to send his baggage and his trunks ahead to Jacksonville so he can go to high school. But he had spent all his money on the ticket, and he didn't have any more money. So he sat down on the stairs of the train station, and all of a sudden, he was crying and just kind of thinking to himself, what am I going to do? And a man who he didn't know, a stranger, a black man in overalls, walked over, asked him what was wrong, and then paid the cost of his baggage so that he could go to Jacksonville. Many years later, Thurman went on to become a Baptist minister and a mentor to a lot of Black Freedom Movement organizers, including James Farmer, Dr. King, many people who you will know in terms of their names, if you don't know his. And when Thurman wrote his autobiography later, he dedicated it to the stranger in the railroad station in Daytona Beach who restored my broken dream 65 years ago. I love that story for a lot of reasons, but primarily I love it because it illustrates our interdependence. It also illustrates that we really are each other's harvest, and that we should always strive to pay it forward. So I hope that we can all think of ourselves as that black man in overalls who paved the way for Howard Thurman to be able to influence the world in major ways. And I'm certain that Dr. Sable was a man like Howard Thurman. And I want to thank you again from the bottom of my heart for this honor and recognition. Thanks so much.